Hello everyone, my name is Pavel Tomm. I'm a freediving instructor trainer and freediving guy in Arctic freediving, freedive with orcas in north of Norway. Today we're going to talk about buoyancy and waiting for freediving. To understand this principle, make your dive more easy, more efficient and safe. There are two forces acting on an object in the water. It's the weight of the object and the buoyancy, the buoyant force. The buoyant force is equal to the weight of the water which is displaced by the object, in this case by your body. I guess that all of you know that you can have some difficulties to dive head down, especially in the beginning. That's because the water is pushing you back up to the surface. How to overcome this problem is to develop a proper technique, have a perfect duck dive and know how to descend. It's not by overweighting yourself. Overweighting is danger. First one is positive buoyancy. It means that you float, the water is pushing you back to the surface. It means that the buoyant force is greater than your weight. Then is the neutral buoyancy, which means that both of these forces are equal. At some level, at some depth, you can theoretically stay forever. You're not sinking, you're not floating. And then of course, it's the negative buoyancy, when your weight is greater than the buoyant force and you're going to sink. The deeper we are, the more are our lungs getting compressed, which means that the buoyancy is changing during our dive. This is something what we can use as a benefit for our deep dives, because in beginning we need to use quite a lot of power to overcome the buoyant force, but at some point we get neutral, then negative, and we start to sink. After the turn is the same story. In beginning we need to move. Last few meters under the surface we can stop moving, and the water is just pushing us back to the surface. It's important to know that as soon as you set up your buoyancy, as soon as you set up your weighting, you are inhaling always a consistent amount of air. Especially in beginning, it's a full breath. If you're not doing any simulations, we're diving always with full inhale. All of us are different, we have different proportion. Someone is more sinking, someone is more floating. This is something what determine your weighting requirements. Shortly, the fatty tissue is floating, muscles are sinking. Fresh water is less dense than the seawater, but also the salinity of the oceans and seas is changing. So you will need a different amount of weights in different seas. Shortly, in the freshwater, you need much less weights than you will need in a seawater. The thicker the wetsuit is, means more weights you need to use. It keeps you warm, but you need to use more weights. Remember, the wetsuit is compressible. So as you descend, wetsuit getting compressed, and after the turn on the bottom, you became very heavy. So that's why if you look at competition, if we're trying to dive very deep, we try to use very thin wetsuit. Not only wetsuit, every other equipment is affecting your buoyancy. So that is important, always you change anything, you will check your buoyancy again. In the pool, you want to be neutral somewhere in between the bottom and the surface. You want to set up your buoyancy as perfect as you can to swim horizontally without using, without wasting some energy. How can we do that? You have full gear on, you have your wetsuit, you have your fins, you have the weighting system. You're taking deep inhale, you use the wall, you do the push wall, maybe one or two kicks, and then you glide. Now you need to be really patient and you really need to wait till the point you stop, because then you're going to see if you sink or if you float. If you end up on the surface, if you're floating, you need more weights. Otherwise, you keep pushing yourself down to stay under the water and you are creating a drag. If you are too heavy, you sink. Of course, it doesn't make sense to dive when you are too heavy, because then you are like a frog. What is really good idea, what kind of weighting system is a good idea to use during the dynamic in the pool, it's neck weight. Because what we want is to have as much weight as possible close to our lungs. It calls trim, the distribution of weight on your body. If you have just weight belt, it wouldn't be perfect. You can make one by yourself, or you can buy some sophisticated one, some special neck weight designed for dynamic disciplines. When the weights are really on your back, above your lungs, then your gliding can be just perfect. Deep diving, it's a different story. We don't want to be neutral 1 meter under the surface like we are in the pool, because we want to relax on the surface. Overweighting is dangerous, I told you in the beginning, but it's also less efficient. The dive, the beginning, your duck dive, could be nice, could be easy, but you can't relax in the beginning of your dive. Imagine yourself floating on the surface or trying to relax on the surface while you keep sinking. Doesn't make any sense. So we need to set up our buoyancy in a different way. We want to be neutral much, much deeper. So what you need to do in the beginning, how you can test this, is to be on the buoy, let it go, stay vertical, take a breath, do passive exhale, and now you cannot sink. Yeah, the surface must stay somewhere on your eye level, floating. If you start sinking, you are way too heavy and you should change it. It's dangerous as well. As I told you, beginning could be nice. You have nice and easy duck dive. But after the turn, you became very heavy and your ascent getting more difficult. You need more energy and it can result in blackout. If you want to dive deeper, what we really need to know is how deep exactly are we neutral. This is important for us to know because we want to know where we can start a free fall. If you don't know that and you start free falling too early, the free fall is getting very slow and you're wasting a lot of time. If you start free falling too late, you're wasting a lot of energy. So how can we really set up the buoyancy? How can we really check how deep are we neutral? What you need to do is to take big breath, and again, always it needs to be a deep inhale. And you slowly descend down to, let's say, 10 meters. Then you turn, so you are head up. Stop the moving of your body. You don't move at all. Do like an OK sign around the line. And now wait. Count to 10. And you will see. If you sink, you are too heavy. If you float, go a bit deeper and check it again. This can really take some time, and it's really normal that it takes a few dives. You can use it as a warm-up. It's quite a good idea. Remember, it's a good idea to set up your buoyancy somewhere approximately around one-third of your dive. So if you're diving to 30 meters, you should set up your buoyancy to 10 meters. 10 meters should be the minimum, otherwise you are too heavy and you are overweighted. If you dive deeper, maybe your buoyancy could be also a bit deeper. It means that you need less weight. Always, you're changing the locations, you free dive, you're changing any kinds of equipment, you need to check it again. Using different suit, your buoyancy will be different. You're diving in different sea, your buoyancy will be different. Use it as a warm-ups and do it always. So, thanks for watching. I hope it helps you a bit. And I'm pretty sure it can make your dive more efficient and more safe.